Good morning, everyone. Agut Evoch, Shavua Toiv. We are continuing here in another week of our learning together in the Sefer from Wolbe, Emunah Yichya, that a person has to learn how to live with their Emunah so that it's coursing through their veins. We're speaking the last week about something called Emunah Chachamim, which is that our Emunah in our sages of our generation, of previous generations, has to be strong, that we understand that they are the conduit and the shaliach, the messengers for the word of Hashem in our generation, in all of the generations throughout history. And our emunah, our belief in what they say, even when it goes against our own nature or goes against our own logic and reasoning, we believe that because of their greatness in Torah and their closer connection they have to the Ribbono Shel Olam, they certainly know what they are talking about. Now today Rav Wolbe is going to come with a different idea in this world of Emunas Chachamim. And he says, what is the power that exists in the world that causes a person to lose their faith and their belief in the Chachamim and the sages? In a very famous sefer called The Duties of Our Heart, he writes the following: be very careful to make sure that you don't divert your steps from the ways of our avos, of our forefathers, and don't go away from the pathways of the Rishonim, of people that came long before us. Don't go into the world of Bidius, which is making things up for yourself. Don't choose from your heart. Don't come up with new ways of life and new customs and new traditions that you think are going to serve you better in this generation. Do not rely upon your own seichel, your own logic and reasoning. And do not listen carefully to their own personal advice that you're giving. And don't dwell within the svara, the reasoning that you yourself have. Do not be chayshid, do not doubt, do not be suspicious of your forefathers. That which they have given over to you in the Messiah, in the oral transmission that we have that goes from generation to generation all the way back to our Sinai, which you think you're going to be chayshid, you're going to suspect them because it's for your own good. Don't contradict the advice that they're giving you when they're doing it what's in your best interest. For you should know, not a single idea of advice that comes up into your mind that you think about might be something that's valuable and important, there's nothing that you could be machadish, could invent or come up with or try to introduce into the world of standard Torah thinking that hasn't been thought about already by previous generations. And with this, he's going to say the following: Chachmei hadoros kvar chashvu al kol hatzdadim she'olim b'da'atenu. The wisest sages of all generations have already spent their time thinking about every angle and detail and train of thought that a person could have. And they checked, they went into all of the world of their thinking and all the different directions and places that they're going. They thought about everything already. In a situation where a person feels that he understands the purpose and the meaning of life better than our sages from the earlier generations, and that perhaps I have a new pathway that I could go down, which is going to serve me better. It's very likely, and we would say certainly likely, that you have not thought through this decision or this advice good enough, and you don't realize all of the negative things that are going to come as a result of doing such a thing. This is where we find ourselves today, in a society that is wrought with technology and modernity and the latest and the greatest that the world itself has to offer us. We sometimes look back into the sayings of our sages of earlier generations and our chachamim who seem detached from this generation, and we say, no, I'll come up with a different way. Says the Chavis Olavavis, the way that Rav Wolbe is explaining it is, don't think they didn't think about this. They were aware of this and they were aware of that, and they're still telling you the best way to live is the way that they are presenting to us. We have what still to learn over here to understand it more, but for now, we'll wish you a wonderful day, a wonderful week, and should have a week that is blessed with Emunas Chachamim, where we see the truth and the quality of the words coming to fruition in front of our very eyes. All the best.